们今天有两位学员会做见证。
There are two participants who will be testifying today.
如果时间允许的话，我们的辅导员Joseph Kim 弟兄也会做见证。
And if time allows, then our counselor, Brother Joseph Kim, will also testify.
那我们第一位要请索菲亚姐妹来做见证。
First, we invite Sister Sophia up to come testify.
索菲亚姐妹她是其实是生长在休斯顿。
Sister Sophia grew up in Houston.
现在到芝加哥去读大学。
And she's now in Chicago for college.
现在是即将进入大学第二年。
About to enter her sophomore year.
那在这一段从休斯顿到芝加哥读大学当中她有一些信仰的体验要跟大家分享。
And this process from going to from Houston to Chicago for college, she has some experiences in faith that she wants to share.
那这也很有可能是我们即将要离开我们所住的地方到外地读书的同龄可能会有的冲击。
These may be challenges that the brothers and sisters who are about to go to college and leave their homes will also face.
因为我们在一个地方久了之后，我们会到一个新的环境，可能会经历很多新的不一样的事物。
Because after we have lived somewhere very long, once we go to a new environment, then we will experience many new things.
那这当中其实对我们信仰就是一个训练。
And this process is a process of training in our faith.
我们现在就请索菲亚姐妹来做见证。
So we now invite Sister Sophia to come testify.
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus Christ, I testify about experiencing God's abidance throughout my college decision journey and my first year of college.
奉主耶稣圣名做见证，关于我要进入大学选择学校的时候，还有我大学第一年的经历。
So early on in my application process, I felt really lost and indecisive.
我在一开始申请大学的时候，我非常的茫然，然后不知道要选择什么。
I knew for sure I would love going to a college close to home.
我知道我很想要在离家近的学校就读。
At the same time, I didn't want to close the doors on any other places God might want to send me.
但同时我也不想要完全不考虑其他神可能为我开的路。
I thank God that at the time he gave me the strength to really pray for his will.
感谢神，我那个时候，神给我力量让我能够求他的旨意。
Each day I would spend more time in prayer, asking God to clearly show me the way that would glorify him most in the end.
我每天都花更多的时间在祷告里面，求他能够带领我，让我可以最终荣耀他的名。
That by the end of the whole process, I would be able to testify of God's great grace.
然后在整个经历过后，我就可以为他的恩典做见证。
Unconditional love and amazing providence.
他没有止境的爱，还有他无限的带领。
So by early April of last year, the decision process winded down.
去年的四月初的时候，申请就是决定大学的过程就差不多结束了。
I had two choices for colleges.
我有两个大学的选择。
One at home in Houston and one in Chicago.
一个在休斯顿离家里近，另外一个是在芝加哥。
My friends at school tried to help me decide.
我在学校的朋友试着帮我做这个决定。
They made me make a pros and cons list.
他们叫我做一个优缺点的一个清单。
They made me make a criteria chart.
然后再照着各样的标准做一张表。
They made me flip a coin.
然后他还叫我掷一个硬币。
But all these methods actually seem to point to the college at home.
但这全部的方法其实都告诉我说要到家里的离家近的学校就读。
And because I love home and comfort, in my heart, I always thought I would go to the college at home.
因为我很喜欢我的家里面，我也很喜欢舒适的感觉，所以我心里一直觉得说我应该会选择那一所学校。
So I could see my parents every week.
这样我每个礼拜都可以看到我的父母。
And continue learning from all the brothers and sisters who really raised me spiritually with their examples of faith.
然后继续跟那些弟兄姐妹在芝加哥教会的弟兄姐妹，那他们是用他们的信仰来抚养我长大的。
But after researching about the program, I wanted to pursue in both colleges.
但是我在做一些研究关于两所学校中我想要读的那个科系的之后。
comparing scholarship amounts,
然后也比较了奖学金的数目
and researching the program, and also praying for God's will,
然后也祷告求神的旨意。
I found that God was giving me many signs that my future lied somewhere else.
我发现神给我很多不同的指示，是告诉我要我的未来是在别处。
I remember during this time I got a call from my prospective music professor at the college at home.
我记得这个时候有我在家附近的那所大学有一个音乐的教授，他打电话给我。
I found it would be almost impossible to do what I wanted to do there.
然后我就发现说我要在那所大学修我想要修的科系基本上是不可能的。
After this call, I knelt down and prayed and cried more than I had ever had in my life.
那这通电话过之后，我就跪下来祷告，然后又边哭边祷告，是比我有史以来哭的最多、最长的一次。
I wasn't willing to face a future other than at the college at home.
所以我知道我要面对的未来不是在我家附近的那所大学。
But I ask God that if it's really His will for me to leave, then give me the strength to know I will be able to do it through His help.
我求神说，假如他要我离开，真的是他的旨意的话，求他给我力量，让我可以过这个经历。
I knew I'd be incredibly lonely in a place 1,000 miles away from home.
我知道说我在这个离家里几千英尺之外的地方会非常的孤单。
In a place where I knew close to no one.
在那里我基本上没有认识任何人。
And where I won't have all the people who have surrounded me my whole life to comfort me.
我也不会有那些我一生中一直在我身边的人来安慰我。
And amazingly and suddenly, all these verses flooded into my head.
很奇妙的，也很突然的，有很多经节就进到了我的脑中。
One of them was John chapter 14, verse 27. You don't have to turn to it, it's fine.
其中一个是约翰福音十四章二十七节。
It was peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
约翰福音十四章二十七节，我留下平安给你们，我将我的平安赐给你们。我所赐的不像世人所赐的，你们心里不要忧愁，也不要胆怯。
And another was Isaiah chapter 43, verses 1 to 2.
另外一个是以赛亚书四十三章一到二节。
It says, "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you."
以赛亚书四十三章一到二节，你不要害怕，因为我救赎了你。我曾听你的名召你，你是属我的。你从水中经过，我必与你同在。你淌过江河，水必不漫过你。你从火中行过，必不被烧，火焰也不着在你身上。
So when all these verses came to my mind, I had faith that all things really do work together for good to those who love God.
这些经节进入我的脑海中之后，我就相信说万事都互相效力，叫爱神的人得益处。
So after that prayer, God showed me or gave me faith to decide to leave home.
在那一次祷告之后，神给了我信心，让我决定离开家。
I knew that not home would force me to truly grow and have spiritual independence.
我知道我离开家之后，就会逼我要真的成长，然后在属灵上面有真正的可以是坚强的。
So that eventually when I'm refined and tested, I shall come forth as gold.
这样子我被试炼之后，我必如金金。
So last year's NYTS really prepared me for the struggles I faced in my first year.
去年的大学神训班真的为了我下一年的各样考验来准备了我。
It wrote on my heart Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10.
那在以赛亚书四十三章一到二节就这样子刻在我的心板上。
You can turn to this one because it'll be referenced a lot.
41 verse 以赛亚书四十一章十节。
Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10.
以赛亚书四十一章十节。
Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10.
以赛亚书四十一章十节。
It says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand."
以赛亚书41:10，你不要害怕，因为我与你同在；不要惊慌，因为我是你的神。我必坚固你，我必帮助你，我必用我公义的右手扶持你。
So my life in the following 10 months would become a living testimony of this verse.
我的在接下来十个月中的生活就切切实实的见证了这一个经节。
With God teaching me always to be thankful in everything.
因为神教导了我要一直拥有感恩的心。
To seek Him at all times.
要一直追求他。
And to know only blessings will follow when we do God's will.
然后也要了解说我们在行他的旨意之后，那他的恩典会随着我们。
So for the first phrase, it says, "Fear not, for I am with you."
所以这个第一个部分说，你不要害怕，因为我与你同在。
So on my last Sabbath in Houston, a sister asked me how long it would be until I returned.
我在休斯顿的最后一个安息日，有一位姐妹问我说，我要多久才会回家？
I told her 12 weeks.
我跟她说12个礼拜。
And she said, "Pretend like it's 6 NYTSs."
然后她跟我说，就把它当作6个神训班。
And this actually made me tear up.
那这个其实让我热泪盈眶。
Because I knew the place I was going was nothing like NYTS.
因为我知道我要去的地方跟神训班完全不一样。
There would be no such spiritual feast.
不是一个灵性的宴席。
Not much spiritual companionship,
也不会有很多属灵的伙伴。
And no such great joy brought on by a lot of praying and reading the Bible.
也不会有从祷告还有读经中得来的喜乐。
However, I carried this thought with me when I left home.
但是我离开家的时候，我就一直抱着这种想法。
Hoping that my next few weeks would be filled with great spiritual growth.
希望我接下来的几个礼拜中会有很大的灵性上面的成长。
So the first few nights of school after my parents left were some of the saddest I have been through.
在我父母离开之后，我在大学过的前几个晚上是我有史以来有过最难过的晚上。
I missed even the smallest things about church and home.
我非常想念教会还有家里的各样事。
I missed hugging my mom and hearing my dad pray in the morning.
我想念抱着我妈妈还有听我爸爸早上的祷告。
I missed eating my sister's quesadillas.
我想念吃我姐姐做的墨西哥馅饼。
I missed cuddling at least 10 kids at church every weekend.
我想念每个周末到教会就可以抱着十几个小孩。
I even missed my grandma asking me if she could use the bathroom when I was using the bathroom.
我还甚至想念我在用厕所的时候，我的祖母问我说可不可以让她用厕所。
And while thinking about all these things, I would soak my pillow every night crying.
我在想这些事的时候，我每天晚上就哭到枕头都湿了。
Thank God I didn't have a roommate at the time.
感谢神，我那个时候还没有室友。
So I'd cry even to the point where I couldn't even breathe.
我会哭到喘不过气来。
And I started to question in my mind.
我就在心中开始在怀疑。
Does Jesus really care for me?
主耶稣真的关心我吗？
And why am I suffering like this if he does?
假如他真的关心我的话，我为什么要这样痛苦？
The only thing that would put me to sleep on these nights was Psalm 23.
我这些晚上中唯一能够让我入眠的就是诗篇第23篇。
I was finally thankful that my mom made me memorize it when I was young.
我也很感谢神说我妈妈在我小时候逼我要把这个章背这篇背起来。
I would hope that God would dry my tears and relieve me with sleep.
我也求神可以擦干我的眼泪，然后让我可以好好入眠。
Just knowing that God was with me, that He was my shepherd, and He is with me, His rod and His staff will comfort me.
我知道说主是我的牧者，他与我同在，他的杖、他的竿会安慰我。
That gave me the assurance I needed to continue and not to fear.
这给了我安慰，让我能够继续向前行，然后不再害怕。
And slowly, despite being away from home,
渐渐的，虽然我不在家中。
I began to sleep easier and enjoy walking every day with God by my side.
但是我每天都可以越来越安稳的入眠，然后可以与主同行。
But of course, at the same time, counting down my NYTSs.
当然，在这个时候，同时我也在数算我还有几个神训班要继续过。
Okay, so Isaiah 41:10, it says, "Be not dismayed, for I am your God."
以赛亚书四十一章十节说，不要惊慌，因为我是你的神。
So despite some of the very harsh, windy days, windy winter days in Chicago,
虽然在芝加哥有很多个很冷、很寒冷，然后风很大的冬天的日子。
The view from my campus reminded me that God is truly sovereign.
我校园的景色也提醒了我说，神真的是万能的。
The skyline of the city,
城市的夜景。
The ever-changing trees,
树上不断在改变的叶子。
And the shimmering blue water of the lake beside campus were always so beautiful.
还有校园中河水是多么灿烂又宝蓝色的，这个让我感受到神的同在。
Even when all the new stresses of school, like homework and projects, loomed over me,
虽然我还是有很多功课上面的，还有要交报告的压力。
God's creation were my very own reminder that God was my own God.
但是神创造的万物提醒了我说，神是我的神。
Keeping me safe and secure.
然后他一直在看顾我，让我平安。
So the next part of Isaiah 41:10 says, "I will strengthen you."
以赛亚书四十一章十节，接下来说，我必坚固你。
So transitioning from a medium-sized church of about 120 members.
从一个大概120个人的教会中，中型的教会中
，to a small church of about 40 to 50 members，
转到一个小型大概40到50个人的教会
，was one of the toughest trials God gave me，
是神给我其中一个最大的考验
，because church was smaller than I was used to，
因为教会比我习惯的还小
，my weaknesses of pride and judgment started to come through。
我的我在骄傲还有论断人的这种心上面的缺点就开始浮出来。
Especially as I observe my new surroundings in church.
尤其是在我观察教会这个新的环境之后。
My heart became filled with a lot of bitterness and contempt.
我的心中就开始充满了苦涩还有厌恶。
That only made me wish I was anywhere but in the place I was.
让我希望说我可以在其他任何一个地方，但不要在这个地方。
It made me question why I had made the decision to move in the first place.
让我开始问我自己说为什么一开始要做这个决定，搬家到这里。
If I should transfer back to school in Houston.
我是否应该转学回去休斯顿
？Or if I should even go to church at all.
或是我是否就不要再去教会了？
So after spending my winter break helping out at SSC and attending CYSC,
我的寒假我的时候我在学生联会帮忙，然后也参加大学的学生联会。
I made the new determination in prayer to see strengths instead of weaknesses.
我重新立志看别人的优点而不是缺点。
Especially in others at church.
尤其是在看教会其他的信徒的时候。
I also took refuge in my spiritual companions.
我也在我的属灵同伴中得到安慰。
My mom and other sisters who lived far away.
这是从我的母亲还有我在其他地方的姐妹朋友们。
Through consistent daily or weekly video chatting and emailing.
透过一直的视讯还有寄 email。
They would always fill my roughest days of disappointment with encouragement and joy.
他们会让我在最困难、最失望的日子中，充满了鼓励还有喜乐。
Through them, God strengthened me immensely.
透过他们，神他不断的在坚定我。
Because every time I thought of a weakness about another person, strength would be replaced instead.
所以我每一次在想到别人的缺点的时候，我就会马上取而代之的想到他们的优点。
My heart started to count all the blessings I observed at church.
我的心中也开始数算我在教会中所看到的各样恩典。
One faithful sister always gave me gifts and handmade cards at the beginning of every school quarter.
一位姐妹，她在每一个学期开始的时候都会给我礼物，还有手工的卡片。
And, I started to realize how loving all the members truly were.
我也开始发觉说，所有的信徒都非常有爱心。
Many of the members were really diligent in cleaning.
然后他们在清扫的工作上面非常的认真。
And they would never complain about driving other people to church.
他们要载别人来教会也从来都不会抱怨。
Even when it was completely out of the way, and they had to take like one or two extra hours.
就算是要绕很远的路，甚至要开一到两个小时更多的路程。
Furthermore, while one of my biggest worries before starting school was transportation,
另外我在开学之前，其中一个最大的担忧就是接送的问题。
Specifically, how to get to church every weekend.
尤其是我要怎么每个礼拜到教会。
God truly took care of me by moving many members to drive me.
但是神真的非常的照顾我，然后也感动了许多弟兄姐妹来开车载我。
And a family even let me stay at their house every Friday night.
有其中一个家庭甚至每个礼拜五晚上都让我住在他们家。
Through reflecting on these things, I couldn't help but feel God's love for me.
透过思想这些事情，我就真的体会到神对我的爱。
Through many of the members in Chicago.
也透过芝加哥的许多信徒。
So the next part of Isaiah 41:10 says, "Yes, I will help you."
以赛亚书四十一章十节接下来说，我必帮助你。
So even in the smallest of matters, I witness God's almighty hand.
就连在最小的事情上，我都看到神大能的手。
There was a time when I had to return something to Amazon.
有一次我需要退还一个在网络上面购买的东西。
And I couldn't find a UPS drop-off station.
然后我找不到一个寄包裹的这种宅急便的地方。
It just so happened that right after I crossed the street from my dorm.
然后刚刚好我从我的宿舍走出去过了一条街之后。
There was a UPS truck that.Drove by.
刚刚好有一个在送包裹的卡车就开过去。
Because there was a lot of traffic at this time, they just rolled to a stop right in front of me.
因为那个时候有塞车，所以他就刚刚好在我的面前停下来。
And I just gave my box to the driver because UPS trucks usually have their right hand side doors open.
所以我就把我的包裹箱子直接给他，因为他们卡车的右边的门是开着的。
It was also easy, and all I could think was, "Thank God, thank God."
所以这全部都非常的容易。然后我心里面唯一可以想到的就是感谢神，感谢神。
There are also times when I plan to remotely join prayers.
也有其他的时候，我计划要从远处一起参加祷告。
That would start at either 9 or 9:30 p.m.
这些祷告会可能在九点或九点半的时候开始。
And well, before those times, usually I'm working on homework.
那在那之前，我通常都在做功课。
God made me finish right at 8:59 or 9:29 p.m.
神也帮助我，让我功课刚刚好在8:59或者是9:29的时候完成。
And while these were seemingly small blessings,
虽然这些似乎是非常小的恩典
，the perfection found in all this timing testifies of God's guidance always at the right time.
但这一些时间点上面完美的配合，也见证了神的带领，尤其是在时间这方面。
I thank God that throughout all this turmoil, I still enjoyed school.
感谢神，让我在这所有的困难中，我还是非常的喜欢学校。
There were often times when I had no idea how to handle the amount of work.
有时候。我完全没有办法承担，不知道怎么样做完我全部需要做的学校的功课。
But I would see over and over again how God would provide.
但我一次又一次的看到神是如何的为我准备。
In winter this year, I took on a very heavy course load.
今年的冬天我修了非常难的课。
One of my classes was a multivariable and vector calculus course.
其中一个我修的课是多变量还有向量的微积分。
And while it was a requirement, I thought I would enjoy it.
虽然这是一个必修课，但是我还觉得说我应该会蛮喜欢这门课的。
I had always loved math in the past.
因为我一直都非常喜欢数学。
It ended up being one of the worst math experiences I've ever been through.
但后来我发觉这是我有史以来经历过可能其中一个最讨厌的数学的一个经历。
The professor made countless mistakes and would always seem lost and confused.
讲授在上课的时候一直做错犯错，然后也都感觉就是不知道在做什么。
I only had a remote idea of what was going on.
那在课堂中在教什么，我大概只有一丁点的理解。
And every time I'd have homework, it would be like trying to cross the Jordan River without the water stopping.
那我每次有功课的时候，就有点像要过约旦河，只是河水没有停下来。
And the day before our homeworks were due and tests were administered.
那在我们功课要交，然后要开始考试的那天之前。
I'd have to binge watch Khan Academy just to have a slight grasp of what I was doing.
我就需要在网络上面看很多网络教学的影片，来知道到底在讲课这样到底在讲什么。
And because of my increased confusion and helplessness as the class went on,
因为我越来越困惑，也越来越无助。
I started praying to God about my worries for the class.
所以我也开始跟神祷告关于我在这门课上面的担忧。
Asking him to save me from stress.
我求他能够卸下我的压力。
To give me wisdom.
能给我智慧。
And to have peace beyond understanding.
然后给我出我意料之外的平安。
While grades aren't everything, I remember very quietly telling God that I wanted a certain grade.
虽然成绩不是所有，但是我记得默默地告诉神说，我希望可以有什么成绩。
If I could get that certain grade, everything would be all right.
假如我可以至少得到拿到这个成绩的话，那所有事情都会没问题。
Through a very, very rare miracle.
通过一个非常难得奇妙的一个神迹。
When the quarter was finished.
当这个学期结束的时候。
And the class finally concluded.
然后这门课也最后终于修完了。
God gave me exactly the grade I wanted.
神就刚刚好给我那一个成绩。
No higher and no less.
不比那个高，也不比那个低。
And God knew the desires of my heart.
神知道我心中所想要的。
And gave me peace in the end, despite the tumultuous journey.
也在最终，虽然有了很多的担忧和烦恼，但是给了我平安。
And while school seems like a very big worry,
虽然学校对我来说是一个很大的压力和担忧的一个地方。
Relying on God is always the answer.
但是依靠神永远都是答案。
And His providence will always be made known.
那他的看顾和全能也显现出来。
So the next part of Isaiah 41:10 says, "I will uphold you with my righteous right hand."
以赛亚书四十一章第十节的最后一个段落说我必用我公义的右手扶持你。
So at school, I started observing others and saw they would always be more ahead of me in their schoolwork.
我在学校的时候，在观察别人的时候，就发现他们在做功课都做得比我快。
They had Friday nights and Saturdays free.
他们的进度都比我快，因为他们星期五晚上跟星期六一整天都有空闲的时间。
I even remember having a conversation with a good friend about not having much of a social life because I go to church on the weekends.
我也记得跟我一个好朋友，学校的好朋友在聊天，然后是关于我其实朋友圈人很少，因为我每个周末都要去教会。
Rather than hanging out with friends.
而不是跟朋友来往。
And most of all, when drives to church felt very long.
尤其是我开到教会的这个路程是非常久的。
I couldn't help but feel loneliness when I'd arrive.
我在到了教会之后，我也会感到非常的孤单。
Service would start.
那个会开始聚会。
And only a small number of people were there.
然后在参加教会的人数也会蛮少的。
Thoughts would come to me again, saying, "Why should I even come?"
我就会开始有这种想法，就是我为什么需要来
？Why can't I just stay home and worship by myself?
为什么我不能待在家里，然后自己崇拜
？I thank God that God helped me through these times to put Him first.
真的很感谢神，在这些时候，神帮助了我，让把他摆在第一位。
Despite my many, many doubts.
虽然我心中有很多的疑惑和不确定。
Matthew 6:33 reminded me to seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness.
马太福音六章三十三节说要先求神的国和神的义。
And all the things that I worried about, schoolwork, social life, and loneliness.
那我其他担忧的事情，像说学校的功课、我的社交圈，还有孤单
，would be taken care of。
他也会照顾。
In prayers and in my thoughts, a question would come up。
在祷告中，还有在我自己思考的时候，就会有个问题浮现。
How could I ever disappoint God by not going to church？
我怎么能因为不去教会而这样子让神失望呢
？How could I ever forsake His love？
我怎么能背弃他的爱？
Soon I noticed how abundantly God would bless me.
之后我开始发觉了神是如何丰丰富富的祝福我。
Especially in all my assignments, despite having less time to work on them than my peers.
虽然我可以做功课的时间比我的学校的朋友少，但是在我的功课上面。
I started to see that God gave me just enough of a social life to not feel lonely.
功课上面一切都还好，然后我的朋友圈也刚刚好，让我不会孤单。
And yet to still feel that I need him.
然后我还是也会继续的感觉到我需要他。
The greatest lesson I learned to combat loneliness and disappointment in church was to lift up my eyes to the hills.
我在教会中的孤单还有失望，我发现最好来解决这个问题的方法就是要举目向山。
To fix my eyes on God alone.
然后定睛仰望神。
At this time, I reflected much on the purpose and reason for going to church.
那这个时候，我也开始在思考说我为什么要去教会。
Now in the absence of my parents，
现在我父母不在。
Specifically, my mom, one of my greatest spiritual friends。
尤其是我其中个属灵最好的同伴，也就是我母亲不在。
And the older sisters and brothers in Houston。
还有在休斯顿那些比我大的弟兄姐妹。
I had lost much of the motivation to attend church。
他们不在我身边之后，我想要去教会的这个动机和欲望也渐渐变少。
I could see that my faith was based on people.
我看得出来说我的信仰很多是在乎于人。
And, I think God really taught me to look at Him.
神真的教导我要看他。
And to focus on God Himself.
然后要专注的仰望神本身。
So just as God looked beyond my faults and saw my need.
所以就像神他看过了我的这些缺点，然后看到我的需要。
I must look beyond the weaknesses and see the needs of the church.
我也不要再看教会的缺点，然后看然后反而是要看教会的需要。
To not just be someone who continually receives.
不要只当一直接受的人。
But someone who continually gives through my servitude.
但是要成为一个可以透过我的侍奉来施受的人。
And even though church at the time didn't give me the need for spiritual companionship,
虽然这个教会没有给我属灵上面的同伴，
I still had to be obedient to God's commandments.
但是我还是需要顺服神的指令。
So after realizing these hard truths,
所以当我学习到这些事情之后，
and seeing the blessings that would follow every Sabbath,
然后也看到每个安息日的时候会随之而来的祝福与恩典，
God answered a lot of my prayers and doubts with great peace.
神就回应了我的各样担忧，然后给了我平安。
When I would journey to church every weekend,
在我每个周末去教会的时候。
So for us, no matter the circumstances of the church we're in,
所以对我们来说，不管我们的环境是怎么样，
because God's name is written upon the church,
不管我们的教会环境是怎么样，因为我们教会有神的名，
and because we love God,
也因为我们爱神，
we will commit ourselves to church,
我们就会对教会有忠心，
even if we sometimes feel discouraged.
虽然我们有时候可能感到灰心，
or don't feel loved by the people in it，
或是感到教会中的人并没有很爱我们。
This is the process of becoming a child to becoming a servant。
但这是从孩童变成仆人的一个经过。
To learn how to love those who are hard to love。
去爱那些很难爱的人。
And how to give rather than to receive。
也要学习如何施而不是受。
So all in all, when my faith was about to fail due to many doubts,
所以总结来说，我的信仰快要失败的时候，
God upheld me with His righteous right hand.
神就用他公义的右手扶持我。
He kept holding on to me all this time.
他在这其中一直的抓紧我。
Giving me reasons again and again to always seek Him first.
给我各样的原因，让我先追求他。
So for any of us going through trials, we feel we can't bear.
所以假如我们其中有任何人在经历我们觉得不能承担的试验，
Think about God's intention of giving us this trial.
我们要想到神给我们这些试炼的用意。
Whether it be living on our own for the first time in college,
不管是到大学第一次独自生活，
coping in a new environment,
开始习惯新的环境，
or seeing past the weaknesses of others,
或是不再去看其他人的缺点，
trust that God's intentions and plans for us are always good.
我们需要相信神的动机还有计划永远都是好的。
And we will be given the strength to continue and to overcome.
神也会加添我们力量，让我们能够继续克服这些困难。
Just as it says in Job 23:10, it's okay, you don't have to turn to it.
就像约伯记23:10所说。
Once we pass through the fire of the tribulation,
我们在经过试炼的这个试炼之后，
and God has tested us,
然后神考验了我们，
we will come forth as gold.
我们必如金金。
Only by trusting in God's heart.
但是我们需要信靠神。
So let's read Isaiah 41:10 again.
所以我们再大家一起读以赛亚书41:10。
It says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand."
你不要害怕，因为我与你同在；不要惊慌，因为我是你的神。我必坚固你，我必帮助你，我必用我公义的右手扶持你。
So I hope that sharing the blessings and experiences I have received,
我希望我在分享完我所经历过的恩典之后，
really compels all of you to reflect about how God has blessed you and been with you also.
你们也会思考神是如何的祝福你们，然后与你们同在。
When we look back on our lives and see how much God has guided and blessed us,
我们在生命中回头来看神是如何的带领我们，祝福我们之后，
we can see how much our Savior has been with us.
我们也可以看到我们的救主是，是这怎样的与我们同在，
has assured us that He is our God.
怎么样的告诉我们说他是我们的神，
has strengthened us.
怎么样的加添我们力量，
helped us.
帮助我们，
and upheld us.
然后扶持我们。
For surely, when God is all we have,
因为当神是我们唯一拥有的，
we have all we ever need.
我们就拥有了我们全部所需的。
So this concludes my testimony.
我的见证到此结束。
May all the glory and praise be unto His holy name.
愿一切荣耀颂赞都归于神的圣名。
Amen.
阿门。
感谢主的恩典，让我们听到一个非常美好的信仰成长的见证。
Thank God for His grace so that we can hear this testimony about a growth in faith.
Sophia 她刚刚离开家，她哭到枕头都湿了，还好。
When Sophia left home, she cried until her pillows were all wet.
床还没有飘起来。
But at least the bed did not float up.
因为诗篇第六篇就记载大卫他说他哭。哭到那个床都飘起来了。
Because in Psalms chapter 6, it says that David cried until the bed lifted up.
那这个就是其实我们信仰成长的开始。
This is the beginning of a growth in faith.
就是说我们要经历孤单。
Meaning that we have to experience loneliness.
那这也是神训练他的工人的必经过程。
And this is a necessary process for God to train His workers.
所以不管是摩西，不管是以利亚，不管是大卫，不管是主耶稣。
No matter whether it is Moses, Elijah, David, or Lord Jesus.
基本上都要先经过孤单的考验。
Basically, they all went through this trial of loneliness.
当我们能够经得起孤单的时候，在这个过程当中，我们又懂得去亲近神，那么我们信仰就提升到更高的境界。
after we can bear loneliness, then through this process, we can learn to draw close to God, and our faith will grow to a higher level.
那他的见证里面也提到，他从一个教会到另外一个教会，看到许多的不一样。
Her testimony also mentioned that she went from one church to another church and saw many differences.
一开始我们到一个新的环境，我们都通常都会以我们自己过去的经验去看待那个教会的人事物。
When we first go to a new environment, we use our old experiences to judge the new things in the church.
通常我们都会有一个先入为主的观念，觉得这样子是非常不好。
Oftentimes we come with prior biases to think that these things are not good.
我们会非常的不适应。
And we cannot adapt.
那是因为我们还不了解为什么这个教会会变成这样，这里面一定有许多人，他们经历了很多的艰难这是我们不知道的过去。
But it's because we cannot understand why the church turned out this way, but it is because the church went through many difficulties and trials.
但是慢慢的我们会如果有祷告靠神，真的是坚守真理。
However, through praying and relying on God and keeping the truth,
我们就会看到其实每一个地方都有神奇妙的作为。
We will see that everywhere there is God's great work.
也都是神让我们来到这里所要得到的学习。
And these are all lessons that God wants us to learn when we go to a new place.
所以当我们到一个教会去的时候，
So when we go to a church,
我们要用心的去观察。
We must observe diligently.
先不要去判断、论断说这个怎么样。
Not to judge about the things there.
因为这需要时间。
Because it takes time.
如果我们跟弟兄姐妹跟着更认识、更熟悉之后，我们才会知道原来这是非常不容易的。
If we get to know the brothers and sisters there, then we will come to realize that what is now the church is very, was very difficult to come to fruition.
听到索菲亚姐妹她怎么样依靠神来做她的功课。
We also heard about how Sister Sophia relied on God to do her homework.
她其实是做了一个非常不容易的决定。
She made a difficult choice.
因为她要有两个主修。
Because she is double majoring.
是两个非常不同的专业。
And these are two very different majors.
这是一般人可能很难做到的。
These are things that most people may not be able to achieve.
因为她同时要用她左边的脑跟她右边的脑。
Because she is using her left brain and her right brain at the same time.
这两个脑要一起用，真的就是手脑并用了。
It is difficult to use both brains at the same time. It is hand brain coordination.
但是我们也看到他很愿意接受挑战。
But we also see that she is willing to face these challenges.
今天很多弟兄姐妹，我们都不愿，我们很怕接受挑战。
Today there are many brothers and sisters who fear facing challenges.
所以很多时候遇到困难的时候，我们就退缩。
So when we meet difficulties, we revert back.
就退到去打电动玩具，打 game.
And we retreat to video games.
退到去喝酒。
To drinking.
退到去跟朋友 hang out， 然后浪费时间，逃避。
To hang out with friends, wasting time and escaping.
其实我们每个人都会在生活当中经历不同的挑战。
But in our lives, everyone faces different kinds of challenges.
我们一定要有愿意靠神的心。
We must have a heart to rely on God.
希望他的经历能够给我们一些提醒。
So we hope that Sister Sophia's experience can caution us.
靠神没有做不到的，一定可以做到。
There is nothing impossible if we rely on God.
而且神的祝福会非常的奇妙。
And God's blessings will be miraculous and wonderful.
但是这当中有一个前提，我们一定要先抓住。
But there must be a prerequisite that we achieve.
我们一定要亲近教会，亲近神。
We must draw close to the church and draw close to God.
我在听他见证的时候，我实际上是深有同感。
When I was listening to her testimony, I felt a lot of empathy.
因为有时候我们到一个教会去，你会发现教会空空的，没有人。
Because sometimes we go to a church and the church is basically empty.
这个时候我们很可能想说，那我不要来算了。
This time, at this point, we might think we might as well not come.
当教会都空空的，没有人的时候，我们去参加聚会的时候，我们的心很不一样的。
When the church is basically empty, when we go to service, our heart is different.
今天如果我们来到会堂守安息日，但是教会时间到了，只有坐两三个人。我们会怎么样想
？Today, if we come to church and to keep the Sabbath, and there are only two or three people sitting in the pews, what would we think?
你来的时候，会堂已经坐满了人，你的感受又是如何
？How is it different from our mentality if we come to the chapel and it is filled?
我们就看到说，其实参加聚会本身就是一个很重要的圣工。
Through this, we see that coming to service itself is a holy work.
就是因为 很多人没有信心来要参加聚会，所以会场才会空空的。
It is because many people do not have the faith to come to service that the chapel will be empty.
他们没有办法把时间分出来，提早来，所以教会要开始聚会的时候没有什么人。
Because they cannot put aside the time to come to service early, so then the chapel is empty.
这个时候，我们如果想说，那我不要来算了。
So at this point, if we think might as well not come.
其实我们就是等，一直都等着别人给我们，我们一直是要接受别人先来参加聚会。让我们可以这样子觉得说来到教会非常温暖，我们一直都在领受。
We are always waiting for others to give and for us to receive because we come to church and we receive warmth, and we feel we enjoy that.
我们一定要反过来想，就是因为教会没有人，所以我要提早到教会来祷告。
But on the flip side, it is because that the chapel is empty, so we have to come early to come pray.
我们一定要把参加聚会当做一个非常重要的圣工。
We must think of coming to service as an important holy work.
因为你的出现可能会激励其他人来的人会。觉得更喜欢来教会。
Because your presence might inspire others to want to come to church.
你不来，更多人就不会来。
If you do not come, then more people will stop coming.
教会就越来越冷淡。
And the church will grow colder and colder.
所以希望我们可以能够从他见证里面得到一些提醒。
So we hope that through Sister Sophia's testimony, we can learn these lessons.
那这个过程其实就是神他训练我们，也是跟我们在很亲密的一个时间。
This process of training from God is also a time where we are very close to God.
他的这个经历虽然只有一年，但是我相信在他的生命里面一定会谨记，不会忘记的。
Even though this experience was only for one year, but I believe that she will never forget this in her life.
就好像在耶利米书第二章第二节里面提到，神他记得他跟以色列百姓最亲密的时候。就是他们在旷野紧紧跟随他的那一段日子。
Like in Jeremiah chapter 2 verse 2, the Lord said that the closest period of time when he felt with the Israelites was when the Israelites followed him closely in the wilderness.
所以我们时常数算主的恩典。
So we must often count the blessings from God.
我们内心就会平静安稳。
So that we can have peace in our hearts.
他们也会生出喜乐。
And we will have joy.
那么最后会看到说神真的很爱我们。
And finally, we will see that God truly loves us.
让我们经历不同的环境。
He lets us experience different environments.
他的手一直会扶持我们。
And his hand will continue to uphold us.
要我们成长。
Because he wants us to grow.
将来能够成为他的有用的仆人。
So that we can be useful servants to him in the future.
感谢主的恩典。
Thank God for his grace.
我们接下来要请 Ivan 弟兄来做见证。
Next, we ask Brother Ivan to come up and testify for us.
他是从凤凰城教会来的。
He is from Phoenix Church.
即将要进入大学。
And he is about to enter college.
所以他要来跟我们见证他在这段成长的过程当中，他怎么样来持守住主的诫命吩咐。
He will testify about how, while he's growing up, he kept God's commands.
相信在他即将进入大学的这个新的生命里面的另外一个篇章的时候，更能够把信仰持守住。
I believe that as he's about to enter this new chapter in his life, which is college, he will be able to further keep his faith.
因为他已经在这个坚守神的命令上已经得到了教训了。
Because in this teaching of keeping God's commandments, he has already learned his lesson.
我们现在就请 Ivan 弟兄来做见证。
We now ask Brother Ivan to come up and testify.
啊 ，Before I share, let's bow our heads together to pray in silence.
我们先大家一同低头默祷。
Amen. Hallelujah! In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I testify.
奉主耶稣圣名作见证。
So since young, it has been a struggle for me to keep the Sabbath as God commanded.
我从小时候开始就对要守安息日觉得是一个非常艰难的任务。
Especially in my heart.
尤其是在我心中。
Just like it is recorded in Isaiah chapter 58, verse 13, how we should not seek our own pleasure.
就像以赛亚书五十三章，
五十八，
五十八章，十三节那里说，我们不应该在安息日的时候，做自己的事。
So in 2017, I plan to attend two separate choir events.
在二零一七年的时候，我计划要参加两个不同的合唱团的活动。
One in February and the other in March.
一个在二月，一个在三月。
So the February event was to be held close to my high school.
二月的那个活动是在我的高中附近。
And I decided to audition because I was very curious about the professional environment that it was supposed to be about.
我决定要面试，因为我对这个专业的环境感到非常的好奇。
And I also had some peer pressure from my choir teacher as well as choir classmates.
我也从我的合唱团的教师还有朋友中也有拿到也有一些压力。
And so even though I knew that I would be giving up a Saturday,
虽然我知道我这样需要放弃一个星期六。
I ended up auditioning and I got in.
但是我还是面试了，然后我也进了。
And so I was set to join the practice on Friday and prepare for the concert Saturday.
所以星期五的时候就有一个练习，然后星期六的时候就有要准备去这个活动。
And everything went as planned on Friday.
星期五的时候所有的事情都照着计划进行。
Until Friday night.
一直到星期五晚上。
Because after the practice on Friday, I was in a rush to eat dinner and go to Friday night service.
因为星期五晚上的练习完之后，我吃晚餐吃得很急，因为我要去参加星期五的安息日聚会。
And so for dinner, there happened to be fish to eat.
那天晚餐刚刚好有鱼。
And normally, I don't have much trouble with like fish bones. You know?
我通常不会对吃鱼骨头有什么问题。
Except this time, I ended up swallowing one larger fish bone, I think.
但这一次我刚刚好就吞了一个还蛮大的鱼骨头
and it hurt
鱼刺然后我就还蛮痛的
yeah and on the car ride to service it still hurt
然后到要去教会的这个车程中还是在痛
and so in my heart I was wondering if God was trying to tell me not to go
在我的心中我就开始想说神是否在告诉我不要去参加
and I couldn't make a decision until the hymn singingBefore service.
然后我是到在开始聚会之前的会前唱诗，我才做了决定。
Because during the hymn singing, when they were singing hymn 135.
因为我在唱诗的时候，他们刚好唱到第135首。
Hymn 135, and then the lyrics in English.
英文的歌词说。
The part where it says, "Go where thy duty calls, fear may assail thee."
他说。去任务召你去的地方，那你的恐惧可能会攻击你。
God is thy strength and shield; he will not fail thee.
那神是你的力量，也是你的盾牌，他不会让你失望。
So when we sang that, I was very moved.
所以当我们唱这首诗的时候，我就心里很感动。
I was both crying and trembling.
我就边颤抖边哭。
And so to me, that was both a stern warning and also an encouragement to keep the Sabbath.
对我来说，这就是神给我一个严厉的警告，也是一个鼓励，让我要守安息日。
So with that, on Saturday morning, I told my choir teacher that I wasn't going.
所以星期六早上，我就跟我的合唱团的教师说，我没有要再去参加活动了。
And also because the pain in my throat still persisted.
因为我的喉咙中的痛还是没有减轻。
Yeah, so thank God I attended the entire Sabbath service.
所以感谢神，我那整个安息日的聚会我都有参加。
But I still ended up visiting the ER because the pain in my throat was still persisting.
但是我之后还是去了急诊室，因为我的喉咙中的疼痛还是继续。
After a long wait, the result was that there was no bone.
在等待了很久之后，出来的结果告诉我说，其实里面没有骨头。
And they suggested maybe it was just a little scarring.
他跟我说，可能只是就是受了一点伤而已。
And thank God, after about 2 days, the pain went away.
那感谢神，在大约两天之后，疼痛就减轻了。
So even though the February event was over.
虽然这个二月的活动已经过了
I still had the March event to think about.
但是我还是需要考虑到我三月的活动
This one was more difficult because it was a high school choir event, like my school choir event.
这个决定比较困难，因为这是我们高中的合唱团的活动
And we decided to go back in 2016.
而且我们在2016年的时候就决定参加了
Because we committed to pay $1,600 per student to go.
而且我们一个学生就付了1600块美元要去
yeah, Because we're going to New York for a weekend.
因为我们是要去纽约，需要一个周末去纽约参加活动。
So by February, I already had paid most of the $1,600 fee.
所以在二月的时候，我就已经把我1600美元的这个费用大概都付完了。
And because I was too scared to give up on my commitment and try to explain to my choir teacher and choir friends.
因为我不敢放弃，我一开始跟他们讲说要去这个活动的事情，然后不敢跟我的合唱团的朋友还有教师解释。
I told myself maybe this will be the last time.
所以我就跟自己说这是最后一次。
To my shock, though, a few weeks before.
在我的我蛮惊讶的是，在那之前的几个礼拜。
There was the ER bill showed up to be $1,600 as well.
急诊室的费用刚刚好是1600美元。
So I had to give that a lot more thought.
所以我就思想了这件事情，想的蛮久的。
Unfortunately, I still gave in to my prior commitment.
但可惜的是，我还是决定要去参加原本说要去的这个活动。
But from here, I already know that God cares about our choices.
但从这个经历，我就知道神他真的非常在乎我们的选择。
So I did go to New York over the weekend.
所以那个周末我就真的去了纽约。
And thank God nothing bad happened.
也感谢神没有任何不好的事情发生。
And also on Saturday I did have time to pray.
然后在星期六的时候我还有时间可以祷告。
So I'm very thankful for that.
所以我对这件事非常的感恩。
And the only thing that I remember now most would be the Sunday evening concert.
我记得最清楚的就是那个星期天的晚上的音乐会。
Because in the middle of the concert, a very clear thought came to me.
因为在音乐会进行当中，有个非常清楚的想法到了我脑海中。
And the thought was, I do not belong here.
这个想法就是我不属于这里。
I feel like that not just from my head, also came from my heart.
而且这感觉像不是只是从我的脑中出来的，但是是从我心中来的一个想法。
So I believe that was a message from God.
所以我相信这是从神而来的一个讯息。
So.With these two events, I learned two lessons.
从这两个活动中，我学习到了两件事。
First, I learned how serious and valuable the Sabbath is.
第一，我学到了安息日是多么的重要，也多么的宝贵。
That Sabbath is a holy gift as well as a command from God.
安息日是一个很神圣的礼物，也是神给我们的一个指令。
And it truly is a sin to reject so great a blessing from our Heavenly Father.
所以假如我们拒绝了这么大的一个恩典的话，那就真的是一个罪。
Sabbath is also a very precious time to have rest from this world.
安息日也是一个非常宝贵的时间，让我们可以得到从这个世界出来的安息。
Because it is a sacred time to come out of the sinful environment.
因为我们这个时候可以离开充满罪恶的环境。
To rest of the worldly burdens,
可以卸下我们世上的重担
and also to just go home after a long week.
然后在一个非常久的星期之后可以回到家
And indeed, thank God that during Sabbath, more and more often, I can sense the joy and peace.
真的感谢神，在安息日的时候，我越来越开始感受到这种平安和喜乐。
Second, I learned more about what fearing God meant.
第二，我也学习到更多什么是敬畏神。
Back to the moment when I was crying and trembling.
回想起我那时候边颤抖边哭的时候。
I realized that every chance that we get to keep God's commandments is more from God's mercy and grace.
我发觉说，我们每次可以谨守主的命令的时候，诫命的时候，真的是他的恩典。
And so fearing God is not negative.
所以敬畏神不是坏事。
It's more about humbling ourselves to not rely on our willpower, but rely on God's mercy and grace.
是关于谦卑自己，让我们能够依靠神的旨意，而不是我们自己的旨意。
And fearing God should also be about learning to genuinely love God.
敬畏神也是关于我们要学习真正的爱神。
Because He first loved us.
因为他先爱我们。
Just as children superficially love, honor, and obey their parents at first,
就如同孩童一开始是只有表面上的孝敬爱父母。
But come to understand and deeply love their parents over time.
但是在经过一段时间之后，就会真的非常的深爱他们的父母。
Our relationship with God starts with a sort of respectful fear.
我们与神的关系一开始可能是比较多尊敬，比较多。
And should mature into the eternal first love, just like in Romans chapter 2, Revelations chapter 2.
但是需要成长到在启示录第二章所说的起初的爱。
And to me, it's like loving God as if we were afraid to lose someone we love.
那对我来说，我们爱神就要像是我们，爱到怕失去他一样。
And so the conclusion from Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 13.
所以传道书十二章十三节所说的。
It says to fear God and keep His commandments.
告诉我们要敬畏神，谨守他的诫命。
And now in the New Testament, knowing that loving God is keeping His commandments.
那我从新约我们也知道，爱神就是要谨守他的诫命。
That fearing God and loving God are pretty much the same and a very good thing.
我们也知道说敬畏神和爱神其实是同等的，然后是一个好事。
I'd love to say that I kept the Sabbath after March 2017.
所以我很想说我从2017年的三月之后就一直都在守安息日。
But that would be a testimony for another time.
但是那就是我之后才要见证的事。
So I hope that this is an encouragement for all of us to pray.
所以我希望这可以鼓励大家要持续的祷告。
To pray to have the heart that fears God.
祷告求神给我们敬畏他的心。
And that because we fear and love God, we can obey His commandments.
因为我们既敬畏又爱神，所以我们可以谨守他的诫命。
And the attitude of that kind of prayer, at least for me.
那这种祷告应该要有的态度，对我来说。
I'd like to refer to verse 3 of hymn 217.
我想要翻到赞美诗第217首。
217 also only in English because Chinese is different.
因为中文的版本是不一样，所以只是英文的歌词。
Yeah. So verse 3 says, O to grace, how great a debtor.
所以第三节说对我们这些欠债的人来说，这是多大的一个恩典。Yeah.
Daily, I'm constrained to be.
然后我每天都被这个是绑住。
Let thy goodness as a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee.
让你的慈爱有如一个束缚一样，像束缚我一直在漂流的心，绑住在你身上。
Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it.
主啊，我知道我很容易游荡。
Prone to leave the God I love.
游浪，然后离开我所爱的神。
Here's my heart, O take and seal it for thy courts above.
现在我献上我的心，请悦纳，然后把它放在你的宫殿中。
All right, this concludes my testimony. May all the glory, honor, and praise be unto God's name.
这结束我的我的分享。愿一切荣耀颂赞归于神。
感谢主的恩典，另外一个非常美好的见证。
Thank God for His grace for this another great testimony.
安息日，这是神的诫命，也是神的祝福。
The Sabbath day is God's commandment and also His blessing.
所以圣经告诉我们，义人基本上是要远离恶事。
The Bible tells us that the righteous man stays away from evil.
要远离恶事的前提，一定是要懂得敬畏神。
And to stay away from evil, the prerequisite is to fear God.
所以艾文弟兄见证他这个遵守安息日的这当中的体验。
So Brother Ivan testified about how he kept the Sabbath.
我们在大学里面有一个挑战。
In college we have a challenge.
就是在星期五的时候，你会觉得很放松。
Which is on Friday nights you'll feel very relaxed.
其实不需要到大学，你到高中的时候，你就觉得 Friday 来的时候你就很 happy。
This is not just in college, but even in high school, when Friday comes, you feel very happy.
因为你就不用做功课，你明天不用上学。
Because you don't need to do homework, and the next day you don't have classes.
你就可以睡到自然醒。
You can sleep until you naturally wake up.
那自然的话，你就聚会就迟到。
And then you'll naturally be late for service.
那有时候睡到自然醒的时候，聚会就不去了，因为就躺在床上安息了。
And sometimes when you sleep till you naturally wake up, you don't even go to service because you have rest on your bed.
所以许多大学的青年信仰之所以退步，其实都是因为忽视安息日而引起的。
So many college youth, their faith worsens at this point because they don't, they're not concerned about the Sabbath.
那忽视安息日的原因，其实是因为星期五晚上的活动太多。
And part of the reason is because on Friday nights they have too many activities.
太过放松的结果就是会在安息日的时候就把它模糊过去了。
So being over relaxed means that the next day on Sabbath, they don't really emphasize it.
渐渐的这就变成一个习惯。
And then it becomes a habit.
所以也是因为这样子，所以有时候我们在安息聚会前的祷告。有时候很少看到青年，因为他们都起得太晚了。
And because of this, during the prayer before Sabbath morning service, we often don't see youth because they don't wake up on time.
因为如果能够准时参加聚会就不错了，何况说要提早半个小时来祷告呢？
If they can come to service on time, that's already good enough. How could they even make it 30 minutes earlier to pray?
但是从艾文弟兄的见证，希望我们能够改变这样的一个倾向。
But from Brother Ivan's testimony, we hope that this phenomenon will change.
安息日其实是很大的祝福。
Sabbath is a great blessing.
我们一定要坚持住。
We must keep it.
不但在大学的阶段，而且是在我们生命当中的每一个安息日都要这样子重视。
Not only in college, but also every single Sabbath day in our life, we have to really be concerned about and emphasize it.
我要用诗篇九十二篇的一段话跟大家互相提醒。
Want to share Psalms chapter 92.
这是诗篇当中唯一一篇有关于安息日的诗歌。
This is the only psalm about the Sabbath.
在这安息日当中，我们要用我们的歌声来颂赞神。
And on the Sabbath day, we will use our voices to praise God.
所以用十弦的乐器和瑟，用弹琴优雅的声音啊，每天早晨传扬你的慈爱，每天晚上传扬你的信实。这是美事。
Verse 2 and 3. To declare your loving kindness in the morning and your faithfulness every night, on an instrument of 10 strings, on the lute and on the harp, with harmonious sound.
我们今天早上在献诗的时候，小丽非常感动。
When we were doing the hymnal presentation this morning, I was very moved.
如果我们的安息日，我们教会弟兄姐妹唱诗都能够像这样子在歌颂神，天上的。众天使跟真神不知道会多么高兴。
If our hymnal worship every Sabbath day could be like this, then our Lord in heaven and all the angels would be so pleased and joyful.
因为当我们都同一个心在歌颂他，很清洁的心歌声在赞美他的时候
，When we are praising God with in one heart and with our voices,
我们的内心都欢呼喜乐。
Our hearts are filled with joy.
那我们也可以在这一天里面享受神的创造。
And on this day, we can enjoy God's creation.
所以我们也是得到力量的从安息日当中得到力量的。
And through Sabbath, we can also gain strength.
所以第四节说，你高举了我的脚，如野牛的脚。我是被新油膏了的。第十节。
Verse 10 says, But my horn you have exalted like a wild ox. I have been anointed with fresh oil.
所以这是我们得力的一个每一周的关键时刻，安息日。
So every week, Sabbath day is the key time when we can gain strength.
第十二节说，义人会发旺像棕树。
Verse 12 says, The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree.
能够生长像黎巴嫩的香柏树。
He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon.
我们会一直在神的殿里面不断的成长，而且结果子不断。
So we will continue to grow and bear fruit in the temple of God.
就算在老的时候，我们仍然结果子。
Even when we are old, we can continue to bear fruit.
所以愿我们都能够很重视安息日。
So may all of us really take the Sabbath seriously.
能够从安息日当中得到神的祝福，让我们信仰坚定不移。
And receive God's blessing and a strong faith on God, the Lord's Sabbath day.
我们的时间已经超过。
So we have passed our time.
所以 Joseph 弟兄的见证就留到下一次。
So Brother Joseph's testimony will have to wait till next time.
Ivan 弟兄也有更多见证。
And Brother Ivan has more testimony.
所以我们明年的 NYTS 我们已经找到要见证的人了。
So next year's NYTS, we have already found the two people who are going to testify.
所以期待我们下一次的。神训班，我们也能够继续来参加。
So we look forward to the next NYTS.
一定能够听到更多美好的见证，生命的分享。
That everyone can attend and enjoy even greater and more great testimonies.
愿一切的颂赞荣耀都归给天上的真神。
May all the praise and glory be unto our heavenly Father.
我们现在低头默祷。
Let us all bow our heads and pray in silence.